I was obsessively thinking about Martha and what had happened, but suddenly a thought took control. The memory of that day at the lake was becoming more and more like a dream when, after awakening, the image becomes more and more faded. Could it be that the memories were a figment of the mind? Had I been the one that hurt my sister? I had always envied her, and now I had taken her identity. I experienced a suffocating pattern of thoughts. I decided to go straight to the lake to retrieve the film rolls. They would tell a different story, I was sure. But deep down, I kept hoping they would confirm my fading memory. Of course the door is locked. The keys aren't hanging on the lock as usual, then they will be in Daddy's study. We live in fear now. My parents are not going to let me go to the lake anymore after Martha's death, so this is the right time. I need to know. The self-doubt I feel is eating me up. I don't have the courage to use the phone. Not right now. Here's the camera flash. Now I can photograph Martha even in the dark. Daddy's stuff. War maps. I've heard everything will play out on this new defensive line. I shouldn't risk it really, but I love watching them sleep. It's the only time they are together and not fighting. July 18th. Everything has changed. I feel like a different person. The best part of me left with Martha. My enthusiasm, my desire to live, and the will to joke around. I find myself alone, left to my own devices, confused with no desire or expectations. I was handling the cameras at the lake and there was a floating body on the water. I don't remember what I was doing before. Yet another memory lapse. That lifeless body was Martha's, my sister. Mummy ran up to me and hugged me, thinking I was Martha and that I, Julia, was dead. I didn't correct her mistake, and now it's too late. If they find out I have been fooling everyone, I don't even want to think about it. I feel terribly guilty pretending to be Martha, pretending to be deaf. I took the photo for Martha's frame. I know it's too late now, and I felt incredible pain placing the picture. I said goodbye to her forever in that moment. I realized she was gone, and there was no going back. I must do one thing for Martha. I must find out what happened. The partisans couldn't have killed her. That's just ridiculous. Lapo is my friend, and he is one of them. He loved us so much. We know all of them, so it's just impossible. I don't have the courage to use the phone. Not right now. It would be nice to have you always by my side, even if it's just a picture. A tripod is necessary to take photos with long exposures. a lens and a roll of infrared film. They can photograph what the naked eye cannot see. I have found what I need to take infrared photos. A photograph is both the present and the past, like a dead body. I don't know what I'm expecting. Maybe it's silly to think you can capture the soul of someone who has died. Her face can no longer tell me if what happened was my fault. I should have known that already. All I can do is head to the lake and get those rolls. I love the night, but this night scares me. In the dark, I can feel all the harm I've caused. It's getting closer with each step. I feel it brushing up against me like a cold wind. I hurt Martha. The closer I get to the lake, the more certain I am of this. How could it not be? I killed her to steal the love that everyone felt for her but didn't feel for me. How could I have done such a thing? German soldiers. Daddy ordered patrols to be carried out near the house, but how could they have lost a helmet? God only knows. Oh no! Damn lamp! Luckily I still have my lighter with me. The cameras are somewhere around here. Two cameras left. One more camera to collect. A shred of fabric here in the woods. How strange. Let's take a photo of it and leave it where it is. That's it. I've got them all. These films are going to help me understand what happened. Now I should rush home to develop them. How could it have ended up here? It looks familiar.
Julia, Julia.
Oh.